Mumbai needs more air, more space, a better quality of life, all at an affordable price. Here, space comes at a premium, and for many in Mumbai, a 1 BHK apartment is a luxury. And in our constant struggle for space, Mumbai city craves a revolution. I'm Milind, and I'm here to give you an all-access pass to Mumbai. Join me as I walk you through India's largest urban makeover project. It's happening right here in Bhendi Bazaar. Under its beaten roofs, Bhendi Bazaar houses about 5,000 families and 2,000 shops, four times the number of people it could accommodate. While it has become a hub for everything, hardware, antiques, jewelry, and some really good food, the flip side is that the infrastructure is still more than 100 years old, unchanged in size and original capacity. Many a times, residents of dilapidated chawls in Mumbai city are averse to moving out, even if it poses a grave risk to their families and to themselves. Let's find out what it really takes to convince these residents to move out. To gather more insight on this situation, I'm meeting Amin Patel, an MLA who has grown up in the neighborhood.
Mada ke baad itna paisa nahi us building ko repair kar sakte hai. Landlord ko itna paisa milta nahi ki wo building ka upkeep kare ya repair ke andar paisa de. Aur building ki halat har saal worse hoti jati. Uske wajah se ek din building gir jati aur log mar jate.
But the reason Bhendi Bazaar really happened is because the SBUT, which is the Saifi Burhani Upliftment Trust, which is run essentially by the Dawoodi Bohra community, they came forward and they said, let us take this forward as a pilot project, as a tribute to their spiritual leader. What prompted your community to get involved and develop this area?
What we were seeing was that a developer or a builder would acquire one or two buildings, pull it down, build something on it. So there were like towers coming up, but they were so thin in nature.
It is a pencil structure surrounded by the dilapidated building. Then they don't have a proper water, proper drainage. Lot of pressure come on infrastructure.
And then the government came out with the initiative of 33-9.
That's right.
Which was a cluster redevelopment.
DCR 33-9. This framework has been created to acquire a cluster of old buildings, provide its residents with transit accommodation, and develop them together as one single project before they can finally be moved back. Consent remains the biggest challenge.
90% people don't want to leave this area.
I have got a very nice house. Now I am satisfied with my house.
उनको ट्रांजिट कैंप में जो भेजा जा रहा है वो बहुत दूर है तो लोग एरिया छोड़ के नहीं जाना चाहते कि वो यहाँ उनके बच्चे की स्कूल है कॉलेजेस है बिजनेस उनका यहाँ पर है
पीपल हु लिव्ड हियर दे हैव बीन लिविंग हियर फॉर मोर देन 150 इयर्स एंड दिस इज अ मोहल्ला काइंड ऑफ एन एटमॉस्फेयर वेयर एक कल्चर होता है एक अपनापन होता है एक दैट अपनापन बाकी रखना था वी बॉट अ पीस ऑफ लैंड इन मजगांव which is about a 10 to 12 minutes walk from here at Anjirwadi and we built 650 transit flats so that people are not disrupted from their social life.
We used to stay in chawls where the toilet is outside but now after coming here how the redevelopment is happening we are very much happy to you know now to move to a flat system where you will have your own personal flat.
Transit is better because there we had only one room. Here we have, they have given us two rooms. So space-wise, it's good over here.
यहाँ आने के बाद में पूरा मतलब lifestyle ही change हो गई है. In fact, ऐसा लग रहा है कि यहाँ भी रह जाए तो कोई problem नहीं है.
What are the sort of timelines now for this project?
600 residential tenants would come back in June of 2019. When they come back, each one of them will have 350 square feet, compact, one bedroom, hall, kitchen, apartment with two bathrooms, 249 buildings, 3,200 residential tenants, 1,250 commercial tenants. It was a Herculean task. But we said, no, with the support of the government, with the support of the tenants who are living here, we will succeed. And today, with God's grace, we have come a long way.
Right.
Today, you don't have any parking facilities in this area, and it's a big problem. The businesses are not flourishing because of one of the reasons is a parking problem.
Sure.
Tomorrow, not only are we going to have parking for each residence, for the commercial, but even for visitors. Today, Bhendi Bazaar only has one tree.
Is that true? Just one tree?
Yeah, just one tree.
Wow.
When the project is done, we are going to have 700 trees and shrubs. So it's going to be a complete green project. It's going to be a smart city where everything will be recycled. And we'll ensure that we don't become a burden on the city, but we facilitate the city to grow further.
We've just done a deep dive into India's largest urban makeover project. A project of this magnitude can't be expected to be smooth sailing all the way. But ultimately, almost 85% of the residents of this area have given their consent for this project. I personally believe that the Bhendi Bazaar redevelopment project will become an important template for the rest of India as we urbanize more and more rapidly.